Because Psalmist is saying that you know that you ought to praise God and worship God because God has been so good to them. Oh, God has blessed them like he has blessed no other nation. And the psalmist is saying to us that we ought to praise God because God has been good to us as well as them, and God delivered them just like he's delivering us. Y'all gonna make me preach this morning. I came in this morning and I was just sore my arm, and y'all know I got arthritis in four places in my neck. And my neck, I haven't slept, I haven't been resting, I've been turning and I've been tossing and I've been complaining. But this morning, I want to just make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Are y'all ready for this? Amen. Oh, when the people cried in Egyptian bondage, God did send a deliverer in Moses, cutting in and out. Okay? I'm letting you hear it together. I don't want to get stopped again. We okay? So when the people cried in Egyptian bondage, God did send a deliverer in Moses. Through a multiplicity of signs and wonders, Moses showed Ramses the second that it was necessary, that he was obligated, that it was a commandment to let God's people go. And surely that was enough for them to make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Or when we examine the fact that God sent a death angel to go and march through the streets of Egypt, and that death was upon the city, and that the Israelites would survive if they had the blood sprinkled over and on the doorpost of where they lived. And when the death angel came by, when they saw the blood, he passed over their houses. Surely that was enough for them to make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Or when we examine the fact, wrong, that God led Israel out of Egypt with a strong hand, that was a reason enough to make a joyful noise unto the Lord. And then when we think of the fact of how they made it out of Egypt, there was seas that stood in their way. And that was when they came to the Red Sea. They saw that the Red Sea was dashing in its white cap waves before them, and the mountains stood majestically before them on both sides of them, and the God of Pharaoh, who was the Egyptian soldier, and chariots was rumbling in hot pursuit and dust behind them. They couldn't go forward, they couldn't go sideways, they couldn't go back. And when they realized that, ooh, Holy Ghost, that there was nowhere to go, all they did was look to Moses, and Moses said, stand still and see the salvation of your God. That was enough for them to make a joyful noise unto the Lord. When the people cried in Egyptian bondage, God did send a deliverer. Amen? Amen. God will bless his people when they are going through struggle. I hope I'm talking to somebody this morning who believes that God will deliver them. Oh, I believe that we ought to make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Well, when we remember that when they became thirsty on another occasion, how God turned a rock into a water fountain. And they were able to drink water in the wilderness, and they found out that God was a rock in a weary land. That was enough itself to make a joyful noise. Oh, we need to be praising God this morning. Now, I come here this morning to make a joyful noise, because not only do I know what God has done for Israel, I know what he has done for me. And that's when I can stand before you, before I address